Hello, I am Anshul Verma. I am a BTech student in IIT Madras and I am working under the supervision of Professor Raghunathan Vengaswamy in the field of droplet microfluidic. In this video, I will brief you with some of the research work that takes place in our droplet microfluidic group in Chennai at IIT Madras. I will first introduce you to elementary droplet microfluidics and discuss a bit about droplet manipulation. Then I will talk a bit about microfluidic networks, in particular microfluidic loop. Then, with the help of a simulation model, I will try to show the possibilities of droplet manipulation in a microfluidic loop. After this, I will talk a bit about my current work, which is droplet detection and classification, and I will end it with possible extensions of my current work. Droplet microfluidics concerns with the flow of droplets in a geometrically constrained small channel. The channels which I use for my experiments have diameter in range of a millimeter. To be able to generate drops, one needs to use two different fluids which do not mix with each other. For my experiments, I use silicone oil and methylene blue solution. They have all the properties essential for droplet generation. Different droplet manipulations like sorting, synchronizing, splitting and merging drops have wide-ranging applications, especially in areas like chemical synthesis. Microfluidic network is a network of channels for fluid flow. Microfluidic loop is one such microfluidic network. Droplets passing through the input junction of the microfluidic loop make a nonlinear decision by choosing one of the branches. This nonlinearity can easily be seen in the Poincaré map of the output junction. For the periodic input droplet flow, the output can be periodic or aperiodic. The Poincaré map of the output junction can be periodic, 2-periodic, 3-periodic, chaotic, etc. It depends on the separation between the drops and their flow rates. The simulation of the process demonstrates one such case. Despite its simplicity, microfluidic loop offers a possibility for various droplet manipulation like sorting, synchronizing and merging. As shown by the simulation model, one can easily manipulate drops in a microfluidic loop by using a serial manipulator. The serial manipulator can pinch the channel, decreasing its area and hence increasing the resistance of one of the branches. Thus, it can control the resistance of one of the branches and hence can affect the flow rates of the drops. The controller used in the model is able to sort different types of drops, in this case different colors of drops, into different branches and synchronize their flow rates to make them merge at the output junction. The controller used in the model is a predictive controller which predicts the future and then manipulates the resistance with the objective to merge the drops at the output junction. To be able to implement various droplet manipulations in a microfluidic network, one needs a sensor. The sensor should be able to detect the drops, allowing the user to predict the future based on the current situation and then take the desired action to achieve droplet manipulation objective. To meet this need, I have designed a sensor using LDR and a light source. LDR is a light dependent resistor whose resistance depends on the intensity and wavelength of light falling on it. The channel is sandwiched between the LDR and the light source. Whenever a drop passes under the LDR, there is a change in intensity of light falling on the LDR. Because of the difference in absorption, reflection and transmission coefficients of the two fluids used for droplet generation. This intensity change leads to resistance change of the LDR, which is related to the voltage signal of the sensor. Considering the realization, in this case we have blue drops and transparent continuous media. Thus, when the blue drops passes under the LDR, there is a change in intensity and wavelength of the light falling on the LDR. This results in resistance change of the LDR, which is captured in the sensor's signal. The sensor's data has a 50 Hz noise, which can easily be removed by filtering. One can use a moving average filter, high pass filter, or a notch filter. For this example, I have used a weighted moving average filter. The filtered data then needs to be processed to find the peaks, because the peaks signifies the drops under the sensor. I have even verified the sensor's output accuracy by cross-checking it with respect to the data obtained from the video of the process. I am currently working on droplet classification using the LDR sensors. The idea here is to use the peak features extracted from the sensor's data and use them to classify drops. A possible extension of the sensor is a 2D pattern sensor, which will be able to detect the pattern formed by these drops in a 2D channel. this can be of huge impact in all the experiments involving 2D channels. The sensors can be installed in different microfluidic networks to study the drop dynamics and implement various droplet manipulations. Another possible extension to the use of the sensor is to use it to find the radius of the drops and to study the droplet generation. For this, one will need to calibrate the sensor's data feature like peak width to find the radius and the velocity of the drops. Thank you.